Hello everyone. Yeah, today I'm going to talk about how to add Singapore bank account in Google Adsense. Oh, there are different type of payment method, but in Singapore there is only one payment method, which is bank transfer. Okay, let's go and see a payment method. Okay, the payment method for cheque is no longer available in Singapore. Okay, this one, the second one, EFT via single euro payment is for the European side. Rapida is for Russia. EFT and wire transfer, both are the same because the funds will be transferred to your bank account. Okay, let's take a look at the supported country for EFT. Okay, these are the supported country. Okay, some country require a test deposit, some don't require. Okay, these are the supported country. You can see I slowly scroll down. You can see Singapore, you need to have a test deposit. Okay, so these are the country. Okay, now I'm going to log in to my AdSense account. Okay, I Google and type AdSense, then I log in. This is my Google Adsense account. Okay, I just received my payment. Okay, it should be in within a few days. Okay, this will be my first payment. Okay, now we need to add in the payment method. So you go to the payment. Okay, before that you will need to do a verification check. They will send you a Google PIN. Okay, to verify your identity. After that, okay, we go to the payment info. Okay, there's a payout threshold, $150 Singapore dollar. So you need to reach close to the threshold, then you can key in your payment method. Okay, so after that you go to the manage payment method. Okay, then okay, this is my payment. This is my bank account detail. Okay, after that you go to the add payment method. Okay, name on your bank account. Okay, my payment method deposit failed 3 times. Okay, I'm using OCBC. Okay, let me tell you why why the payment cannot go through. Okay, the first one, the name on bank account. Okay, this one I put the bank name, which is incorrect. Okay, so the deposit, test deposit declined. So the second time I put my name. After that, everything, bank code, branch code, account number. Okay, after that, decline again. So, I was thinking why it declined? Maybe because my name, I put all capital letter. So I try again. I put my name first word in front, the first character is capital letter. So I try again. After that, decline again. Oh, rejected again. I was like, wow, OCBC bank, how to solve? Okay, how to solve? After that, I realized, actually, the account number, OCBC should have, I think, 10 number, right? Okay, the account number you should minus off your branch code. Okay, let's say 10 digit, you minus off the branch code, so left 7 digit. If I know it's 10 digit, okay, let me see. I think it's 10 digit. Yeah, 10 digit. So you need to minus off the branch, minus off the branch code, and then you put the account number. But I didn't. After that, I changed to POSB. So my account now is, I'm using POSB for the payment. Okay. Yeah, okay, let me show you the bank code. What is the bank code for different bank? Okay. We'll go to this PDF. Okay. Okay. For UOB, the bank code will be 7375. Okay. The branch code. Okay, the branch code you put there 230. Branch code, because when you open the bank account at different bank, there's a different branch code. So you can Google and search a bank UOB branch code. Then you see, okay, usually the first three digit is your branch code. Okay, then the UOB virtual account. Okay. Bank code still the same because it's UOB and branch code 001. So I think 001 is the default branch code lah. Then DBS bank code is 7171, branch code 005. Okay, DBS branch code is you can Google also, different bank have different branch code. Okay, DBS 10 digit account number. So for POSB is bank code 7171. Okay. Then the branch code 081. 081, so far I know it's the default one. Apply to all POSB bank because the account number is only 10 digit. So 081 is the default one. Okay. For OCBC, bank code 7339. Branch code 550. Okay. 10 digit. Is supposed to have 10 digit account number. So yes, you can see drop first three digit of account number for the account number field. So you need to minus off the first three digit. So your account number is actually only 7 digit. Okay, you must take note for the OCBC. For the HSBC, HSBC bank code is 7232. Branch code you can Google search also as well. Okay. As HSBC also the same. You must drop first three digit of account number for the account field. Okay. HSBC personal. Okay. HSBC corporate and personal, the bank code is different, so you take note. Branch code you can Google. Also drop the first three digit of account number for the account field. Okay, SBI bank code 7791, branch code as usual, go and search. Then okay, you also need to drop the first three digit for the account field. Standard Chartered. Okay, Standard Chartered bank code 9496, branch code, you Google and search, and then use a 0 plus first two digit for the branch code. Okay, so that's all the bank detail. Once you fill in all the bank detail, after that you can set as primary payment method. Okay. Then after that, they will send you a test deposit, which a few send. Okay. They send to my POSB account and then I got it. I think it's 18 cent. Okay. So after verify, they will, after that, you can wait for the payment. Okay, the payment will be the auto lah. Okay. So my last payment was 21st April. Okay. The first money I got is 104, which was less than the $150 payout, threshold payout. So I wait for the next one, the $400. But after that, it deduct the US tax, Google, I think the US tax. So after that, I got $371. This one is my first payout lah. Okay, so I think that's all. If any question, feel free to comment below. If you are new to this channel, please like and subscribe to my channel. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, goodbye.